Hi guys, it's Alia. Welcome back to my channel. So I wanted to show you some updates that I have been working on. Let me just get it over here. Prior to doing, oh my gosh, am I even in frame? Sorry, hold on, I got just my mirror again. There we go. You know what? Sorry for shaking the camera. Let's try that. There we go. I think that's better. Okay. So prior to doing the little break that I took and did some of those traveler's notebooks that I showed in the last video, I was working on, and you know what? I'm not even sure if I showed it or not. I was working on a new kit from, well, a new kit for me from Ellsiebels BookShelf. It's another design team project I'm working on. The kit that I'm using is called Winter Forest. And originally I thought, well, actually originally I wanted to make kind of like a chunky one, but at the same time, I didn't want it to be big and chunky. And then when I got everything together, I thought I wanted to do two small, let me just show you, two small traveler's notebooks. You know, I divided the kit in half. But then I thought, let me stick to my original plan and make a big chunky one. So it's technically the traveler's notebook size, but it's kind of like a chunky one. So, I mean, as you can see, let me just take the inside out. I did do the cover, and this is a page from the kit. It's just so wintry, and it's like, it's kind of like holiday-ish, but it's more winter. I mean, in all the pages, there's snow, but there's also that little feeling of the holiday times, but not necessarily. So I picked this fabric originally for it when I had gone to Walmart, I don't know how many weeks ago, because obviously it's snowflakes, but also it's sort of kind of like a Christmas color themed, a little bit like the gold and silver. So, and it is a hardcover. I made the cover with chipboard. And then I thought, this is what the image that I wanted to use on the cover. It's the little cabin, it's all snow covered, and I'd love to live here because it's just so awesome. Look at that, isn't it? And then I think it goes really well with the fabric. So that's going to be on. I'm not sure what I'm going to put like in the background behind it. It might be plain. I haven't thought that far ahead. So I have the cover all set. I have everything in here decorated. Though when I put it in, I saw that there is some little, you know, fluff and puff here, but not as much on the top or and none in the middle because I didn't do any tabs at all. So what I want to do is just do a few little tabbies here and there with lace. That way too, I can also add charms to it because there's no charms hanging in there at all. And you know, when I do some chunky ones, you know, I love to put some charms in there. So I will end up putting some bits of lace, a little on the top, some on the middle, and then, you know, maybe one or two on the bottom just to keep it uniform. And then also I'm going to hang some charms on it. Now, I was going to say something else. I forgot. So, I mean, this is the project. This is where I am in the project so far. This is the first signature, and this was actually my favorite, I almost said embellishment. Well, kind of like embellishment, sort of. It is a top tuck. This does flip down, but I really like the way this looks. It's really simple, but it's like really elegant to me. You know, so and I have, you know, lots of different pieces, you know, I'll give you a little quick look through. Not too much though, because you know, we'll have to do the final walkthrough. Look at this, there's the deer. Some little stuff there. Actually, I just flip it this way. So, you know, I mean, you see little bits. And of course, you know, when I do the final flip through, I'll go in more into detail about each page. I will show you each page. But I just kind of wanted to give you an update of where I am in this project. I'm really excited, though, that I did go with my original plan and keep the hardcover, because it's just so cool. I mean, it's my size. I love the Traveler's Notebook size. Granted, this is a little wider. Let me actually, I don't remember. So the cover is 4 3/4 by 8 3/4. So it is a little taller and it is a little wider than a normal Traveler's Notebook. Actually, it's a half an inch each way, which isn't too bad. I think the spine, I wrote it down somewhere. Oh, here it is. The spine is 1.5 inches wide. So, I think it's going to be really cute when it is finished because of the size. You know what I mean? I really like this. And I'm thinking too, in the future, and possibly after this project, because after I finish this, I actually have an order for somebody that I have to finish. Well, actually, I have to start and finish quickly. But I think I want to do another Traveler's Notebook size, one signature, but make it a hardcover. You know, so it'll be, you know, just a signature like this, except instead of like a soft cover or a fabric cover like I normally would do, I want to do a hard chipboard cover. Because I don't know, there's just something about the size and it being hardcover that I absolutely, absolutely love. So I'm going to have to see what kit I want to use first of all. Second of all, I don't know. There was really no second of all. I just said second of all because I said second of all because it comes after first of all. So, so that is my update for this chunky Traveler's Notebook. That's kind of two things you don't hear in one sentence, because a Traveler's Notebook usually is not a chunky notebook. Well, in my videos, it's not. I'm sure other people out there have done the same exact thing. But for me, this is the first time, so I was really excited about it. And, you know, I wanted to just jump on and show you what I have so far. And I have so many more ideas that's coming into my head, actually, even now as I'm doing the video. So stay tuned, because I'm really excited for some up-and-coming projects that I am going to get into. And actually, I need to get off the camera, write them down so I don't forget. Because I come up with all these ideas in my head, but since I don't write them down, I always forget. And then, I don't know, I struggle. So, going to go write them down now. I hope you liked this. I hope you like me coming on and just kind of giving you updates about the projects that I'm working on at the time. And you know, if you haven't subscribed to me, please do, because I would appreciate it, number one. And number two, I try to come out with some interesting videos. So as always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye.